My dear students, today I am going to take diversity of living world. Earth is a complex structure consisting of both living and non-living things. Living and non-living things exist together in our planet. So the complex structure of the earth consisting of living and non-living things, that we say it is the biosphere. Biosphere is the complex structure of earth consisting of living and non-living things. It is our duty to differentiate living organism from non-living things. We have to differentiate living organism from non-living things. There are some characteristic features of living organism by which anyone can differentiate this is a living organism and this is non-living thing. That is the attributes of the living organism. What are the attributes of the living organism? That is listed as number one, growth, reproduction, excretion, irritability, respiration, metabolism, and nutrition. These are all some of the characteristic features of the living organism. Those characteristic features cannot be seen in non-living things. We'll see in detail about some of the attributes of living organism. The first characteristic feature is growth. Growth is an intrinsic property of all living organism. Growth takes place due to the increase in the cells, both in number and mass. The growth will multiply inside the living organism due to cell division. One cell divides, redivides, and produces a number of cells. That's why growth takes place. The growth in plants is indefinite because there is no restriction to the growth of the plants. But in the case of animals, growth is restricted, growth is definite. Definite type of growth takes place because animals will grow only a certain age, certain period. Say for example, in the case of human being, the growth takes place up to 48 or 40 to 45 age. After that, no growth takes place. So that is the definite growth as far as animals are concerned. The second point you can differentiate between the growth of the plants and animal is, in the case of plants, growth takes place in certain localized areas where meristems present. Growth takes place at the tip of the shoot, at the tip of the root, in the nodal region, on the lateral side of the stem and root. You know what is nodal region? It is a part of the stem which produces either leaves, flowers, or branches. That is the nodal region. So these are all the localized areas where actually multiplication of the cells takes place that leads to the growth of the organism. There are two types of growth. One is extrinsic growth and the second one is intrinsic growth. The extrinsic growth is the growth of the non-living things. In the case of non-living object, growth takes place simply by aggregation of materials on the surface. Say for example, in the case of mountains, in the case of boulders, and in the case of sand mounds, Mankuvier. Sand mounds means Mankuvier. in this non-living thing, non-living object, growth takes place by simple aggregation of materials on the surface. That is one type of growth. It is taking place only in the case of non-living object. Intrinsic growth, the second type is intrinsic growth. It is the growth of the living organism. All the living organisms grow by the addition of the protoplasm, new protoplasm within the cells. So here in all the living organism, growth is possible due to the addition of new protoplasm in each and every cell. That's why growth takes place. Such a type of growth is called extensive growth. In the case of unicellular organism like bacteria and amoeba, growth takes place by simple division of the cell. Binary fission, multiple fission, like that. There are two types of fission takes place as far as bacteria and amoeba are concerned. In bacteria, one cell divides equally into two and form two organisms, that is called binary fission. So here in the case of bacteria and amoeba, it is considered as a reproduction. The growth takes place by cell division, and that is considered as a reproduction. So that's the growth and reproduction are mutually inclusive events as far as bacteria and amoeba are concerned. So that is the intrinsic growth. This is intrinsic growth. Right, come to the next one, cellular structures. Based on the nature of the cell, based on the structure of the cell, the organisms are classified into, the living organisms are classified into prokaryotic organism and eukaryotic organism. Already in the 10th standard you might have studied about prokaryotic organism and eukaryotic organism. What are prokaryotes? Prokaryotes are unicellular organism. They are most primitive organism. And they don't have definite nucleus and membrane-bound cell organelles like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies, etc. are absent. Say for example, in the case of bacteria, in the case of blue-green algae, prokaryotic cells are there. They are considered as, these two are considered as a prokaryotic organism, having prokaryotic cell. What is a prokaryotic cell? When the cell is unicellular, when the cell is only one cell and consists, and that is primitive, and that cell contains membrane-bound nucleus and membrane-bound organelles are absent in that cell. Such organism is called prokaryotic organism. The eukaryotic organisms are either unicellular or multicellular, and they are considered as the most advanced organism. In the eukaryotic organism, nucleus, definite nucleus present, and most of the membrane-bound organelles are present. Definite nucleus means nucleus with nuclear membrane. That is considered as a definite nucleus. Such a definite nucleus is absent in prokaryotic organism because no nuclear membrane present in the nucleus. Nuclear material may be present, but nuclear membrane will be absent. Such a nucleus is undeveloped nucleus. But here, definite nucleus, well-developed nucleus present as far as eukaryotic organisms are concerned. Come to the reproduction. Reproduction also a unique characteristic feature of the living organism. It's a fundamental characteristic features of all the living organism. Here, the organism will produce new organism of his own kind, of his own species. That is, the reproduction is a tendency to perpetuate his own species. That is the reproduction. Reproduction can be classified into two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. What is asexual reproduction? When the union of gametes, when the gametes are not involved in the reproduction, and that is called asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, in asexual reproduction, a number of progenies, new organisms are produced, and all are having one or more or less similar. Those similar to those of the parents, no variation can be seen in progenies. Whereas in the case of sexual reproduction, union of male and female gametes takes place so that zygote is formed. From the zygote, embryo will be produced. Embryo develop into new organism. In the organism, newly formed organism, variations are seen. Variation can be seen through recombination. So that is the sexual reproduction. A number of asexual reproductive methods are seen. These are all the asexual reproductive methods. These are all the several methods of asexual reproduction. Number one, by coridia, by budding, by fission, by fragmentation, by protonema, by regeneration. What is coridia? First one is by coridia. In the case of Aspergillus, the mycelium will produce, this is the erect mycelium, produce spores outside. This is the conidia spores. Each one dispersed by wind, reaching the moist suitable substratum and grow into a new mycelium of Aspergillus or Penicillium. So reproduction takes place by conidia in this. Next, by budding. Budding means it is taking place in the case of Hydra and yeast. The parent plant is unicellular. This is the structure of the yeast. From the parent plant, from the parent organism, a bud-like structure, a projection will be formed from the surface of the body. This will grow into the parent organism, detached from the parent organism, and grow into a new organism. This is the new organism. This is budding. By means of budding, new organism will be produced. Just around the parent plant, a number of projections will be produced. Each one grow in size, and after maturity, detach from the parent organism and form a new organism and grow as a new organism. That is called budding. That is taking place in the case of Hydra and yeast. The next one is fission. Already we have seen in bacteria and amoeba, one organism divides equally into two and form two organisms. This is called binary fission. Another method is there multiple fission. In multiple fission, one organism divides and form several organisms. One organism gives rise to several organisms. But as far as binary fission is concerned, one organism gives rise to only two organisms. Here, two organisms will be produced by binary fission. But in multiple fission, one organism gives rise to a number of organisms. This is binary fission as well as multiple fission takes place in the Hydra and bacteria and amoeba. Next one is fragmentation. In the case of Spirogyra, fragmentation takes place. Spirogyra is a filamentous green alga. Here, cells are arranged one above the other. This is the filament of Spirogyra. The filament of Spirogyra is broken into a number of pieces, number of fragments. Each one grow into a new thallus of Spirogyra. Suppose there are four fragments are formed by breaking the Spirogyra filament. Four new Spirogyra organism will be produced by cell division. That is the fragmentation. Next one, Protonema. In the case of mosses, bryophytic plant. Here, the spore germinate into a branched green branched filamentous structure. This is called Protonema. The Protonema produces new plant like this. Several new plants will appear from the branched green branched Protonema. So that is the Protonema. By Protonema, asexual reproduction takes place. Next one, binary regeneration. Regeneration in the case of planaria. It is, planaria is an animal. Here, the whole animal is cut off into a number of segments, number of part. Each one will produce the whole organism. This will produce the whole. This also will produce the whole organism. This part also will produce all organism. So that is the regeneration in the case of planaria. In between fragmentation and regeneration, no much difference. This is taking place in plants, this is taking place in animals. That is the things. So that's all the types of asexual reproduction. That's all.